Hi, how are you? I'm so glad you're here. I have something very special for you today, something that is a little bit different than I normally do. Now, I'm going to ask you some questions. Do you ever feel like you don't know what your purpose is? Do you ever feel like you're spinning your wheels? Well, I have the solution for you. It is simple, it is easy, and it is something you can start today. Hi, I'm Adriana Girdler. I'm president of Cornerstone Dynamics and a productivity expert. And I'm here today to share with you something that's very special and magical, but super easy to do. Now, when I'm with my clients, I work with tons of their team members, and we're constantly looking to get their organizations on track, ensure their organizations have purpose, and we're moving forward efficiently, effectively. And whenever I do that, I always get their team members coming up to me saying, Adriana, how do we do this for me? I want to have purpose. I want to get on track. I want to do those things. I look at you, Adriana, and you have it all. And you know what? I feel pretty good about it because I do have it all. I have everything that I'm meant to do in my lifetime. I am so connected with my purpose. And that is what I want to share with you today, is how to get connected to your purpose. Because by understanding what your purpose is, you are going to live life successfully. Because success is not about what you get. It's not about checking things off that list. It's really about going inward. It's about connecting to your heart's desire. And it's about living your purpose every day, waking up and knowing, this is what I get to do today. Now, I'm going to share with you how to do it. And that's the visual visioning. Right here is my personal vision. It guides me every day. I have it everywhere. I have it on mouse pads. I have it in my home office. This is my office. I have it on screen share. Why? Because I make decisions with it. It's not something that I just look at occasionally. I wake up and I go, this is who I am and this is what I'm about. It allows me to make those yes and no decisions, because I promise you, there are doors of opportunity everywhere. And the question is, are you open to it? Are your eyes open to it? And the only way you know is if you're connected to your vision. Now, how do you do this? I've been doing this for a long time. And over the years, I've tried many different things. What I've learned and what I find to be the most easiest way that really gets you to where you want to go is turning it into a visual vision and putting a story around it and putting really good pieces of information that are going to act as a guide, because your vision is your tool. It's your tool every day to get you where you want to go on your purpose. So the first thing that I always do with all my clients is we benchmark. Where are we at today? So where are you at today? Do you know where you are today? And what I mean by that is not where you physically are today, but where are you from a standpoint of what you want out of life? Are you doing everything that people are expecting you to do? So you're not even living your own passion or purpose, but you're living what other people think you should be doing? Or are you connected to your desires? Or are you so afraid to connect to your desires that you don't do anything? This benchmarking is important because it allows you to figure out what it is that you're doing and to understand where to put your attention to. So if you are doing everything what everyone is telling you to do, I call that the shoulds, shoulding on yourself. There's a right or wrong associated with it. You really got to evaluate that, because I promise you, 10 years from now, you'll be upset. Like, what have I done? I've wasted my life. How much time are you spending on your desires and your passion? If you're not spending enough time there, then you really got to ask your question, why? Why? And even more importantly, are you just doing things that are neutral? So are you just kind of just hanging out? It's really critical to know this benchmark, because that's going to help guide you and propel you to that next level. Now, another thing that you really need that helps with vision statements whenever you want to make that decision and use it as yes and no in your life is to understand what your values are. Your values are core to who you are. They are the essence of your character. They are your line in the sand. You live them 24/7. This is what distinguishes people, because you can have a vision, you can be very clear, but sometimes you need to understand what your value is. And by really living your value, you're going to be able to connect the value and the vision that really gets you towards what you really want to do. Now, values are something you got to live every day, 24/7. You don't live them when they're convenient, because some people do that. And you really got to ask some tough questions around values. Like, if someone gave you $1 million, would you drop that value? Well, if you just said yes, guess what? That's not a value. Values are something that hold true to you no matter what. Now, I have a website, myvisualvision.com. Check it out, because I have a laundry list of values. I want you to take a look at it. This is ethically who you are, your character. This is what distinguishes you from other people, are your values. So now that you've benchmarked, now that you understand what your values are, I want you to create a story. So this is a little bit different than what we're taught in a business perspective, because we're taught the one-liners, that they should just be really quick, that you can just roll them off your tongue. The problem with that is we don't connect with it. They can be too obtuse. So you want to have some detail. I call it the story. What's your story? Who are you? What do you want to do? Now, in order to create stories, it can be a little overwhelming. So I like to put things into what I call buckets. So family is really important to me. So what I want out of family, what do I want out of friends, what I want out of a career, what do I want that's really important to me, like music, what do I want from other things? So you really start to think about it. Who am I? What's my story? What really am I passionate about? And start putting them into buckets. And when you do this, you want to create your story. So what are the things that are really important to you? You want it to be not too pigeonholed where it's like detailed details that you're not going to be able to see other opportunities and say yes to them, but you want it broad enough that you're going to be able to see stuff, and maybe you wouldn't have connected the two points together, but guess what? Now that you understand and you have that story around it, you'll be able to connect those points and actually be able to do something that you never thought you would ever do. Now, I have a really good example of that on my TED Talk, because I talk about the importance of visioning, and that's exactly what happened to me with musical notes. Now, I'm not gonna go into detail with that, but it is a pretty cool story, one I'm really excited about that changed my business. So if you have an opportunity and you're really interested in it, check it out. Last but not least, once you've benchmarked, you understand where you're at, you've got your values, you have your story, you wanna put it in a picture. Picture's worth 1,000 words. I cannot even express how important that is. We see a picture, it gives us emotion. We get connected to it. And with a picture, a lot of things are told to me right now with just a glance. So if you're gonna live this and you can use it as a tool, you want to change it or put it into a picture. I actually got mine professionally done. I have it on Canvas because that's how important it is to me. This is your life. This is your purpose. Successful people understand this. And that's why they're successful, because they're living their purpose. They're connected to their heart's desires. And they ensure that everything they do moves them forward to that. And that's what I want to share with you, because it's a question I get asked all the time. How do you do it? And it's not that I'm special, different, or unique. I'm just a person like you. And guess what? We're all special. We're all different. We're all unique. And you don't have to spin your wheels whatsoever. You just have to be very clear with what you are. Don't get distracted with what I call the white noise of life. I want you to focus inward, not on the outward stuff. Now, if you're really inspired, I have some amazing resources for you. Check out my website, myvisualvision.com, totally dedicated to visioning, because that's how really passionate I am about it. My TED Talk is on there too, if you want to get some inspiration. But there's lots of things on the web. There's tons of things you can do. There's even workbooks that you can go through and you can fill out, and it can take you through the journey of creating your own personal vision statement. But more importantly, turn it into a visual. It's a powerful tool. Now, on that note, I hope I inspired you. Please, you know what? Give me some comments below. Tell me if you've actually done this. I would love to hear from you. And if you've actually gone to the step of creating your own visual, send it to me. I would love to partake and see what inspires you. Thanks so much. Until my next video. See ya.